discussed.
How about you, Angel? What are they saying?
I think the biggest thing that people come up to me and say is like just seeing ASL being incorporated into the show and how there's actually a few fans that's deaf and hard of hearing that feel like they're inspired to just do whatever they want to do or have roles in. Just because they see me and Connie do what we do, you know what I mean? And even with our hearing, you know, problem.
It's so cool because it's more inclusive in the show, but also it's really fun to see how you guys use that in the storytelling, where you need to be quiet and it's actually an advantage sometimes. I mean, I'm sure it must be fun. So all you guys are learning sign language, correct? How is that coming along?
It's kind of hard.
It's good. You're good though.
But thanks, mate. Concentrating so much on learning it for that scene, and then we move on to another scene, and I've forgotten everything before.
It's like school.
Exactly. That
describes my college experience. So I've heard that you guys have made up some signs for Walking Dead specific things. Is that right? Like, can you give me some examples?
So we have sign names for a certain character. So like Michonne, Magna, Luke. Also like Walker, we call them singles. Yeah,
singles.
We just say random like signs on set, like snake.
Yeah. Watch out for the snake. Wasn't that? Yeah. But also just like head top and stuff. So actually a lot of the signs that I remember are completely inappropriate for real life. Like I'd just be like, I know where Hilltop is. Is there a place called Hilltop? I can ask you how to get to Hilltop. Nothing else.
So you mean the signals? The one you did for Magno, what was that?
Fire.
How does that
work? Because it's fire. So, sign names usually have something to do with your personality or even physical traits. So Magno is a hothead. So, like, just fire, whatever is fire. So that's why it comes from here. But she also has a lot of love. Yimiko, because she's the fire with the cheekbones. And then
she.
Let's work on that. I always like the one for Birdie. You know when we say like, that was like, oh man, he's like the guy that we lost before you meet us, and he has like the paisley shirt. The one that it's a very emotional scene with the Mag and all of us. But I love that sign, and I love how it connects emotionally to it. It's like, oh man, Bernie, man. And when you do that, as an actor, it really grounds you. It was really cool to learn.
Interesting. I heard Trump was like this or something.
Yeah, flapping back. Hair. No, what is it?
That's right, yeah.
Is that true? That is hilarious. Is it because of his hair? That is hilarious. Okay, good. I think we have a question over here. What's your name?
Hi, my name is Molly, and I have a question for all of you.
You must stand because
we're the... Oh,
yeah. Oh, there you go. You are standing.
If you hadn't been captured or found by Judith and captured by the Whisperers instead, how do you think your lives would have changed on the show, and what are your thoughts on Alpha?
We were asked that, weren't we? I think on the Talking Dead, do you remember that? It is a good question, because I feel like our group's pretty adaptable. So I feel like we would have gone with Alpha, but we also would have grouped together on the side and been like, guys, we're going to find our moment when we can split, because these guys are crazy.
These masks are really smelly. I'm about to lose it.
Fit in for now, and then we'll find the moment to go.
Yeah, that's what I think we would have done. I don't know, where do you guys go?
Oh, I totally agree. We would adapt and get the hell out.
Yeah, because you guys, by this point, are kind of a unit, and you you've had experiences with different communities, but you're tighter together than you are. I still feel like you're kind of like that, right? You're new to Hilltop, so you're tighter together. I could see you guys almost just saying, this isn't for me, and taking it all together.
I think Magna feels that way a lot, because I'm so used to being with my group outside, and that's what we've, you know, what we've done for the last decade. And I totally like Hilltop and the idea of all that, but I think Magna has a hard time adapting. And I think, yeah, I think she's more comfortable on the road just with her people.
So what if AMC decided to do a spin-off with you guys on the road? Would you be down for that?
Oh, I would love that. It would be a lot of laughter for you guys.
We call it Near the Walking Dead. We need seven more spin-offs. Sorry.
Let's go into the question. Hey, over here, what's your name?
Well, it's Paul. My question is for Eleanor and Nadia. I know you haven't been on the show for that long, but what's your standout moment so far?
Standout moment? In terms of our characters in the show?
Yes.
I think making out with my girl. Yeah.
It was fun,
yeah.
Right?
It was. We wanted more.
Yeah,
we wanted
do.
More. We were like, we want our tongues to be out. And then AMC was like, no, guys, keep it together. Not.
Yeah, we're prepared to go all the way.
Yeah. Yeah. Rehearsing before day and night.
We just for the art.
Rehearsing day and night for weeks.
Well, we know each other. We cornered Greg Nicotero at a party, and we were like, hey, we need to see more of Magna and you
before. I was there for that.
Yes. We really cornered him, right? We were like, hey, they're in a relationship. We need to see more of them being in a relationship. And then in the next episode, we were like, oh, he listened. They did it. They put it in. So, yeah, we were pretty happy about that.